नियतिकृतनियमरहितां ह्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. सो देर् वर् अ कपल् आफ् जस्ट् वन् आर् टु क्वश्चन्स् दट् समोन् हेड् आस्ड्. सो वन् इस् अबौट् द वर्ड् कदा इन् श्रुतिकटुत्वं. लेट् मी जस्ट् लुक् एट् इट्. सो लास्ट् क्लास् वि सा श्रुतिकटु च्युतसंस्कृति अप्रयुक्तम् एण्ड् असमर्थम्. Right, we have to start with nihitartham. So before that, let me just look at that Shrutikatu question and then I will address that. So the word kada has been used in that shloka with labhate. So generally the word kada lapsyate, when will I get, right? It will be used in lit lakara, but there is a sutram which says it can also be used in present tense, even though it is not present. So kada gamishyami is a more appropriate word, but there is a sutra, Panini sutram, which says vibhasha kada karkyoho, and you can use latlakara for kada also. So that is an option that is there. Someone had asked why it is in latlakara and not in lritlakara. That was one of the questions. The other question was more interesting because all of you have studied Auchitya Vichara in your first, your first year. Let me just go through that question. So, aren't Auchitya and Dosha, isn't it not the same? Because the examples for Shruti Katu and everything mimics that Auchityam that we have read. That is the Pada Auchityam, etc. Now the idea here, even when I was teaching that Auchitya Vicharam, I said that the very fact that Alankarikas are talking about Madhyama Kavya, Adhama Kavya and Dosha, that itself shows that this Auchitya is a more enveloping concept than these aspects that the Alankarikas are talking about. So Alankarikas talk about Madhyama Kavya, Uttama Kavya, Adhama Kavya, and then doshas and Alankara Dosha, Pada Dosha, Padamsha Dosha. Anything arises because there is an absence of Auchityam. So Auchitya and Dosha is not the same. Or anauchityam and dosham. See, anauchityam can exist in many things. Dosha is that which exists in pada, padamsha and all these aspects. Why the dosha even arises is because there is a lack of propriety in the way the poet expresses the idea. There is a lack of auchityam in the idea that the poet exists, expresses. That is why even a dhvani kavya attains the status of a guni bhuta or an adhama kavya, because there is a lack of auchitya. There is no auchityam. So auchityam is more like a concept which covers the entire gamut of the kavya. Okay, so it is not equal to dosha there. The dosha arises because there is no auchityam. So that is the distinguishing feature between the two of them. Now we will go to this dosha. We looked at asamartham. Where yat tadartham patyate nacha tatra asya shaktihi, and we saw the example tirthantareshu snanena samuparchita satkritihi surasrotasvinim esha hanti samprati sadaram. The word hanti has been used in the meaning of gamanartham, and that is not proper. Now the next one is called nihatartham yad ubayartham aprasiddhe arthe prayuktam yatha. I don't think I will put a slide here. So if you have the text, yes, or I can share the text on screen for those who don't have the text, if you want. Shall I do that? Okay. Let me share the text. Is that fine? You have the text, then okay. For those who don't have the text, just let me know, because I will keep shifting between one type of text and another, so it may be difficult to show on the slide. Okay. Nihatartham yat ubayartham. So for nihatartham, the dosha he tries to point out here is one word will have two meanings, and the word that is the meaning in which the word is used, which is very popular, has not been used by the poet, but he uses the unpopular meaning of that word. Okay, sorry. So nihatartham yat ubayartham, yat padam ubayartham asti, that word which has two meanings, in that among those two meanings aprasiddhe arthe prayuktam, it is being used in the aprasiddha or the unpopular meaning is being used here. So yatha yavaka rasa ardra pada prahara shonita kachena daitena mugdha sadvasa tarala vilokya parichumbita sahasa. Here it's like a small story that is there in the shlokam. The Nayika and the Nayaka have had a quarrel here. Both of them have fought about something or the other. Now, mainly the Nayaka has done some aparadha, he has made some mistake towards the Nayika. Now he is falling at her feet. Okay, the Daitaha is beloved. The beloved is falling at her feet and asking for forgiveness. She is still angry. The Nayika is still angry. So she is pushing him away. While pushing him away, she uses her leg and pushes him away. Now, he has fallen at her feet. The Nayaka has fallen at her feet. And his head is at her feet. She is trying to push the Nayaka away. And while pushing him away, she uses her leg and pushes his head. Okay? Now, her leg has been beautifully decorated with the, alta, alaktaka rasam. So she has alaktaka rasam or a red color paint on her legs to decorate her legs. And with that, she is pushing the Nayaka away. So that alaktaka rasam, which is very fresh, ardram, it is wet. So yavaka rasa is alaktaka rasam that you wear on your leg for dancing and all, they wear that. Okay, so yavaka rasa is that red color paint on the leg. So yavaka rasa ardra padam, the feet is wet because of that alaktaka rasam, and with that foot she is hitting. The Nayika is hitting the Nayaka. So pada prahara, and because of that, what happens? That rasam goes on to the head of that Nayaka, and it looks like blood. So shonita means red. That's all it means. Okay, here. So shonita kachena, kacha is hair, daitena, it is an adjective for the daita, for the beloved, where his head is reddish in color because of being hit by the wet legs of the Nayika. And it is wet because of the yavaka rasam, which is alaktaka rasam. Right? Now, daitena, the moment she hits him and there is a red color paint on his head, she thinks it is blood. And she gets very upset. She is very afraid of that. Sadhvasa tarala mugdha. Sadhvasa, being afraid, and tarala, chanchala. So she doesn't know what. The moment you see something like that, you see blood on somebody's face and you think it is because of your action, you will immediately get agitated because of that. So sadhvasa tarala. She's very afraid and agitated. Now this Nayaka, the beloved, he finds this as an opportunity and immediately he hugs her and kisses her. Sahasa parichambita. Two things there. One is he wants to immediately, allay her fears. Don't be afraid. He wants to tell her that you need not be afraid. It is, after all, I am not hurt. That is one thing. The other thing is he has gotten an opportunity and she will forgive him easily now because of that mistake. Okay, so two things are achieved by this action. So yavaka rasa ardra pada prahara shonita kachena daitena sadvasatarala mugdha vilokya, or mugdha sadvasatarala vilokya. She was seen by the Nayaka to be very afraid and tarala agitated. Hence, sahasa parichumbita, she was immediately kissed by the Nayaka. Right? Shloka is very beautiful. We have to look at the dosham now. अत्र शोणितशब्दस्य रुधिरलक्षणेन अर्थेन उज्ज्वलीकृतत्वरूपः अर्थः व्यवधीयते. नौ द वर्ड् शोणित द प्रसिद्धार्थ देर् आर् टु मीनिङ्ग्स् हियर् वन् इस् द प्रसिद्धार्थं विच् इस् द मोमेण्ट् यु हियर् द वर्ड् शोणित इट् गिव्स् अस् दि ऐडिया आफ् ब्लड् and if you say blood then here that word immediately gives rise to jugupsa which is bibatsa rasam and your shringara rasam or that beautiful irsha vipralamba shringaram is gone okay or even some the bhava sandhi is gone here right the first one is the vipralamba where she is angry about it and then the next is where she is happy about being hugged by him and kissed by him. So that bhava sandhi, where the two bhavams are meeting, that is gone because of the word shonita is being used in the unpopular meaning of ujjvali kritam. Ujjvali kritam means it is being bright or it is reddish in color. So there the word shonita, which is rudhira lakshanena, it is an indicatory of rudhira or blood. Whereas rudhira lakshanena arthena, by the meaning of the of blood for the word shonita, the poet does not want to express blood here. He wants to say ujjvali kritatva rupaha artha, that is the vivakshita artha. So he wants to indicate that it is just merely red, that's all. Ishat raktam ityartha. So ujjvali kritam means ishat araktam. So that is the artha, that is the meaning that the poet wishes to convey, which is vyavadhiyate, tiraskriyate. So it is being completely overshadowed. So the meaning of redness is being overshadowed by the meaning which is more popular, that is blood. Okay, very beautiful shlokam. So as again to point out the difference between auchityam and pada dosham, here, because the word shonita does not have auchityam, it gives rise to pada dosha. So it is a karyakarana bhava there. Auchitya and dosha are not the same. Auchitya anauchityam gives rise to, or auchitya rahityam gives rise to dosha. Okay, keep that very clear when you read all the doshas here. Okay, so atra शोणितशब्दस्य रुधिरलक्षणेन अर्थेन उज्ज्वलीकृतरूपः अर्थः व्यवधीयते आर् तिरस्क्रियते. नेक्स्ट् वि गो टु अनुचितार्थम्. अनुचितार्थं देर् विल् बि ईवन् मोर् कन्फ्यूशन् इफ् यु थिङ्क् आफ् औचित्यविचार हियर्, बट् कीप् इट् वेरि क्लियर्. औचित्यराहित्यं गिव्स् रैस् टु दोष. ओके, नेक्स्ट् अनुचितत्वम्. अनुचितत्वम् इस् वेर् दि ऐडिया एक्स्प्रेस्ड् इस् इन्अप्रोप्रियेट् आर् इट् केन् ईवन् गिव् रैस् टु अ विरोध अर्थ. वन्स् वि लुक् एट् द एक्साम्पल् वि विल् अण्डर्स्टाण्ड्. तपस्विभिर्या सुचिरेण लभ्यते, प्रयत्नतः सत्रिभिरिष्यते च या, प्रयान्ति ताम् आशु गतिं यशस्विनः, ranashvamede pashutam upagataha. Someone is praising the warriors who die in a battlefield. Now when you die, there are Mahabharata, there is a shloka which the vyakhyata also says, dvavimau purushavyagra suryamandala bhedinau parivrat yoga yuktascha ranecha abhimukaha hataha. So two people in this world, purhe purushavyagra dvavimau dvau imau purushau suryamandala bhedinau, they cross the suryamandala and attain swarga. Two people only attain swarga in this world. Who are those two people? Yogayuktaha parivrat, parivrat or a sannyasi who is yogayuktaha, who is completely practicing that yoga and is in the samadhi state. Sannyasi who is moksha, mumukshu, one who wishes to attain moksha, and as a tapasvi who has been practicing all the different aspects of yoga, he attains swargam. And the other person who attains Swarga is Yahacha Rane Abhimukaha Hataha. Not someone who is running away from the battlefield and is being hit by another person, so he will attain Swarga. No. Veera Swargam is attained by a warrior who stands in front of someone and faces the fight and dies in the battlefield. Okay. Dvavimau Purusha Vyagra Suryamandala Bhedinau Parivrad Yoga Yuktascha Raneja Abhimukho Hataha. One who faces people and dies. Here, he talks of the gati that the warriors attain, the sthanam that the warriors attain. What do they get? Tam gatim ashuprayanti. Tam gatim, they attain that gati, that status, ashu, very quickly they attain that position. Ya gatihi tapasvibihi ya suchirena labhyate. One who performs tapas have to perform for a long time, and then after a lot of difficulties only they get it. So ya gatihi, that gati is which is attained labhyate suchirena tapasvibihi. Suchirena, after a long time tapasvis attain that gati, which is swargam. Next is satribihi cha ya prayatnataha ishyate. Prayatnataha satribihi prayatnataha yaha ishyate. So tapasvis have to just sit and perform tapas. Next is satri. Satra is yaga. Those people who perform yaga, satribihi, by the people who perform yaga, prayatnataha, by making an effort. That is, they have to perform a lot of yagas, and that yaga will give a punya, and that punya is called apurvam, which is not going to give you a fruit immediately. You don't know when you will attain that swarga also. So after a long time, after a lot of effort, you don't know if you just perform one yagam, will you get that swarga? You don't know. You, if you perform three yagas, maybe I will get that also, you don't know. So after how many yagas you will get, nobody is aware of that. So people who perform the yaga, satribihi, prayatnataha ya ishyate, that which is desired, ya gatihi, that position which is desired by the yaga performers, after making an effort, prayatnataha or out of effort, tam gatim ashuprayanti, those people who are in the rana or in the battlefield, they quickly attain that gati. How? So rana ashwamedhe pashutam gataha upagataha. Rana, this battlefield is like an ashwamedha yagam, and in the ashwamedha yaga, the animal which is getting sacrificed, pashutam upagataha, the animal that which has attained that pashuta. Pashuta means the quality of being a pashu in the ashwamedha yagam. So rana ashwamedhe, here it is a rupakalankaram, where the battlefield is equal to the ashwamedha yaga. It is as pure as the ashwamedha yaga. So in the ashwamedha yaga, the pashu which attains a gati, which is being killed there or sacrificed there in that ashwamedha yagam, those people who are being sacrificed in the battlefield like an animal in the ashwamedha yaga, they attain a gati very quickly. Now here, the moment we see the word pashu, that is the problem word here, right? Atra pashu padam kataradam abhivyanakti iti anuchitartham. Now we are trying to talk of a warrior, and we have to suggest their viratvam and not kataratvam. Kataratvam means cowardice. Here, the moment you say pashutam gataha, an animal which is being sacrificed in an ashwamedha yaga, that animal, you don't know what sort of a mentality that animal has in that sacrifice. It is actually in a very pitiable state. They tie it to that yupam. There is a yupa daru, there is a staff, and they tie that animal to that. It actually indicates cowardice more than viratvam. Whereas in a battlefield, you have to show your parakrama, and because of that parakrama, they attain that viraswargam. Correct? So the moment he uses the word pashutam upagataha, they have attained the status of a pashu, those warriors who have attained the status of pashu, immediately kataratam vyanakti, abhivyanakti. It suggests the meaning of cowardice and not Viratvam, which is what is anticipated here. Okay, hence Anuchitartha means you are using the idea to be expressed is said in a very inappropriate manner. The idea to be expressed is Viratvam, whereas Kataratvam is actually the opposite of that. Okay. Next is Nirarthakam. This is a very easy one. Nirarthakam Padapurana Matra Prayojanam Chadi Padam. Cha Adi Padam. Cha Vai Tu Hi. These are all words that are used for Nirarthaka. These are just used for Padapurana Matra Prayojanam. So there are a lot of words which we use, like cha, vai, tu, he. These are very popular in Purana and Itihasa. If you look at Mahabharatam, if you read Mahabharatam, Ramayanam, or even Bhagavata Puranam, any Puranam for that matter, which we have to cover some 10,000, 50,000 shlokas, it is very natural to use certain words for Padapuranam. Padapuranam means in a meter, there should be 8 syllables for Anushtup meter. There are restrictions for how to construct a shloka. In that, if you have written the shloka but there is one word missing, that is, it is less by one akshara, then you can just include he, cha, etc. Actually, these words have a meaning and can have an importance in a shlokam if used appropriately. Okay? The example he gives here is Utpulla Kamala Kesara Paraga Gauradyute Mamahi Gauri Abhivanchitam Prasidhyatu Bhagavati Yushmat Prasadena. Hey Bhagavati Gauri, Bhagavati Bhaga itself means Aishwaryasya Samagrasya Dharmasya Yashasasriya Jnana Vairagya Yoschaiva Shannam Bhagaiti Irana. There are 6 qualities that are called together Bhaga. And Bhagavan means Bhagaha Asya Asti Iti Bhagavan or Bhagaha Asyaha Asti Iti Bhagavati. So those qualities are Aishwarya, Samagrasya Dharmasya, Dharma, Yashas, Kirti, Shreyaha, Prosperity, that is spiritual prosperity, Jnanam, Vairagya. These are the 6 qualities that make up Bhagavan. So Bhagavati, Yushmat Prasadena, because of your grace, Abhivanchitam Mama Prasidhyatu. Mama Abhivanchitam, whatever I desire, let it be fulfilled. Okay? Prasidhyatu, let it be fulfilled. So the adjective he gives here for Bhagavati is Gauri. One is, hey Gauri. So you don't know whether he's talking about Shiva, Lakshmi or Saraswati or any other Devata for that matter. So here he addresses which Bhagavati he's talking about, which is Gauri, Shiva's wife. Now the adjective he gives for Shiva here, the Parvati here is Utpulla Kamala Kesara Paraga Gauradyute. She has a form which is Gauradyuti, which has the Kanti, which has a white Kanti, Gauradyuti, which is equal to the pollen grains that are found in a full bloom lotus. Utpulla Kamala, a bloomed, well-bloomed lotus. It's Kesara Paraga, the pollen grains that are there in its Kesara, in that stamen that is there inside the flower. Okay, so Kesara Paraga, and she has a Gaura Kanti like that of that pollen grain. Hey Gauri, hey Bhagavati, Yushmat Prasadena, Abhivanchitam Prasidhyatu. Now here he uses the word he in order to complete that Arya Chandas. It is an Arya Chandas which has a certain Lakshana where there have to be so many matras that are there. Right? There are different types of Arya Chandas where there can be 18, 20, etc. Here, Mama Hi Gauri. Now, what is the meaning of He Shabdaha? He can be used in many meaning. One is He is Avadharanartham, or He can be Heto. Heto Avadharanecha. He Shabdaha Upayujyate. Now, Hetu means because of this reason, I am doing this. So Mama Hi, where are you joining that He? Because I am here? No, that will not make any sense there. So Prayojana and avadharanam. Avadharanam means the you are saying indeed it is because of the fact that. So there is no extra emphasis that is needed in the shloka by that word he. You don't need that at all. Correct? So the word he is actually nirarthakam. There is no meaning to that usage of that word. Okay, actually the shloka has so many different other doshas also, where the visheshana itself, utpulla kamala kesara itself, that visheshanam is apushtartham. When you look at the artha doshas that he is going to talk about, where he will talk about apushtartha, where it is not contributing towards the meaning of that shlokam. See, utpulla kamala kesara paraga gauradyute, if I have to describe the beauty of Gauri, then it is more appropriate in the sense of where she probably is with Shiva, or you are trying to describe the Shrungara Rasa that is there between Shiva and Parvati, then it makes sense. It has no effect on a devotee who is trying to ask for what he wants. So that is another dosham that is there. And even prasidhyatu, prasidhyatu means prakarshena siddhyatu. Even that upasarga is also useless there. But the relevant here for the pada dosham is the word he that is being used, and he is normally used for both hetu and avadharanartham. There is no such effect that is there because of he. Okay, utpulla kamala kesara paraga gauradyute mamahi gauri abhivanchitam prasidhyatu bhagavati yushmat prasadena atra hi shabdaha. Hi shabda is nirarthakatva dosha yukta. Next is avachakam. Avachakam yatha, he gives us three shlokas. Yeah, three examples for avachakatvam. And the first two are very similar. It is just an alternative meaning, alternative example. The first two examples are the same mostly. The second example, or the third example, is for upasarga. Now, avachakam, what is the definition he gives here? I wanted to say about how, you know, he, when you use in nirarthakam, when we were talking about how cha, vai, and tu, he, and all are irrelevant in certain shlokas, and they use it only for padapuranam, there are some shlokas which even use these things as a way to you know, emphasize what is being given in the idea. I'm not sure if I mentioned that. Anyway, let's move on to the next dosham, which is avachakam yatha avandhya gopasya vihanturapadam bhavanti vashya swayameva dehinaha amarsha shunyena janasya jantuna najata hardena na vidvishadaraha. This is in Kiratarjaniyam, it is in the first canto of Kiratarjaniyam, where the Vanechara, that is, there is a spy who has been appointed by Yudhishthira to go and check out how Duryodhana is taking care of the kingdom. Yudhishthira is in the forest. He wants to know how Duryodhana is taking care, or he is ruling. It is a very common practice of kings to find out how the other kings are ruling. Correct? Now, okay, let me first explain the shloka and the meaning, and then I will come to how the dosha is and why the dosha also does not exist, because this shloka is something I cannot accept that there is a dosha. Bharavi is one of the Mahakavi, and his Kavyam Kiratarjaniyam is also a Mahakavyam there. And to say that there is a dosham, this is not the place to say that. Anyway, so this is after the Vanechara comes and says that Duryodhana is ruling the kingdom in a very beautiful manner. You cannot find fault in the way he is ruling the kingdom. He may be a bad person towards Yudhishthira, but as far as the subjects go, it seems as if the people will even forget that there existed a righteous king called Yudhishthira. That is how the Vanechara comes and portrays the scene to Yudhishthira. Now, Yudhishthira, after listening to the whole thing, before Yudhishthira can even respond to the spy, Draupadi, who is there standing beside Yudhishthira, talks about, she immediately gets angry about the way Duryodhana has been ruling, and she wants to provoke anger in Yudhishthira. Yudhishthira, there is no reaction in him. He is the most calm person in times of adversities. That is why he is the fit king. Whereas Draupadi, she immediately is very impulsive and she wants to instill that anger in Yudhishthira. So she says, Avandhya kopasya vihantu rapadam bhavanti vashya swayameva dehinaha. Dehinaha, people who have sharira, people who have taken a form and taken a janma in this world, they will very easily, they of their own accord, swayameva, of their own wish, they will become vashyaha. They will become attracted towards people whose kopa, avandhya, is very successful. Those who have an anger which is very successful, and apadam vihantuhu, those who can divert the calamities that are there in the world. That is, those who can destroy, vihanta. Vihanta is a nashayita. A person who destroys apat. Apat is the dangers that can affect the subjects of the world. And that person who can destroy those dangers, apadam vihantuhu. Vihantuhu is also in Shashti Vibhakti. Apadam vihantuhu is an adjective for avandhya kopasya and janasya. So, avandhya kopasya, one who has an anger which is sthane. Sthane kopaha is very important. Not a person who is very impulsive and shouts at every moment is not proper. You have to look at the, in Tamil we have an expression, yadam purul yeval. The proper place, there is a proper place and proper time to show anger. That is when it can be effective. That is called avandhya kopa. Avandhya kopa is nishphala kopa. Saphala kopa is avandhya kopa. Avandhya kopasya janasya tatha apadam vihantuhu janasya dehinaha janaha swayameva vashyaha bhavanti. Of their own accord they are being attracted, or they surrender themselves to people who have a very successful anger, or who are capable of destroying the calamities that come for people. Okay, take that as one sentence. So now, in contrast, amarsha shunyena janena jantuna saha. Amarsha shunyena, amarsha is kopa. Kopa rahita rahitena jantuna is equal to a jantu, janma matram there, right? So he is, there is no use for his janma. He doesn't have any kopa, he doesn't have an anger. So a person who is devoid of anger, if with that person, jata hardena, if someone has a sneham towards a person who does not have any anger at all, not even sthane kopa, then there is no use for that. Na adaraha, nobody will respect. No, there is no adaraha, means no use for having friendship with a person who has no anger. Okay, can we have an enmity towards that person who has no anger? Vidvisha api na daraha. See, if a person is an enemy, at some point the enemy should fear that person, right? I have an enemy. If one is an enemy to another person, it means you are fearing, or you hate something, or there is a fear. Why is there a hate? Because you fear something in that person. Not totally afraid or anything, but you are apprehensive about something, that some quality that the other person has. Correct? So that is daraha. You have to split it and say vidvisha. Amarsha shunyena jantuna saha vidvisha. Because of enmity with a person who does not have anger, there is no daraha or no fear having enmity with a person who has no anger. This is how you have to explain the shloka. And if you explain the shloka in this manner, there is no dosham at all. The situation is Draupadi is very angry. She wants to instill anger in Yudhishthira. And so she talks about the difference In a person who shows anger, who has saphalatva in his anger, and whose there is no anger in someone, and hence there is a nishpalatva. There is no point in a person who does not have anger. So there is no use for a friendship, nor is there any freer by having enmity towards that person, because he is not going to act. Okay. Now keep that aside. Now we have to look at why Mammatacharya shows a dosha here. Because he interprets the word apat, apadam, in a different manner. Apat can be described in two ways. One is apat as an opposite to sampat. Sampat means aishwaryam or wealth. So apat automatically becomes the opposite of wealth or daridryam. That is where Mammata makes a mistake. He makes a mistake of saying that apat has to be interpreted as daridryam. Now, the relevance here is, see, in this context, you cannot say it as apat as daridryam at all. So let me try to explain it in that manner so that we can understand what the dosham is. You're all going to write an exam and you'll have to explain it in that manner. So avandhya kopasya, a person whose anger is useless, apadam vihantuhu, and a person who is capable of removing the daridryam or poverty that is there among people. Take it as that, not calamities or disaster. Okay, so apadam vihantuhu, a person who is capable of removing the daridryam or poverty in a people. So janaha swayameva vashyaha bhavanti. So general people normally surrender themselves to a person whose anger is very successful and who is capable of destroying poverty. Amarsha shunyena jantunacha. So amarsha shunyena is taken in contrast to avandhya kopa. So avandhya kopa is a successful anger. Amarsha shunya is a person who is devoid of anger. Now apadam vihantuhu, as opposing to apadam vihantuhu, a person who destroys poverty, the opposite of that, in the sense, it should be data. So adata, a person who does not give or does not do charity. So he takes the meaning of jantu, the word, to mean as a person who does not give charity. But the word jantu has no capability of expressing that meaning. Hence, it is avachakatvam. You understand the dosha here? If the problem arises because Mammata has taken the meaning of apat as samriddhi, as opposite to samriddhi, samriddhi rahitam. And hence the word jantuna amarsha shunyena jata hardena. So the meaning here, how he starts off, is amarsha shunyena. So ashuraha, a person who does not have parakrama, a person who is not a warrior, tena saha, if a person does not have anger, tena saha vidvisha with a shatru, shatruna saha. So amarsha shunyena shatruna saha. So the entire anvaya will change for this. So amarsha shunyena vidvisha saha, someone who does not have kopa, the tadrisha shatruna saha janasya, shatru rupena sthitasya daraha bhayam na bhavati. Okay, that is one meaning. The other part of the sentence is where, as an opposite to apadam vihantuhu, we say jata hardena jantuna saha. So jata hardena, jata snehena mitrena jantuna, kintu saha na data bhavati. He does not give charity, but you have a sneham towards that person. Tena saha adaraha na bhavati. So we have no sort of a mitra rupasya tasya janasya adaraha na bhavati. So there is no respect for a person who does not give charity, but you have a sneham towards that person. Now, do you get the meaning? Now here, atra, जन्तुपदम् अदातरि अर्थे विवक्षितम्. द पोएट विशेस टू कन्वे द मीनिंग ऑफ अदाता, वन हू डज नॉट गिव चैरिटी. ही वॉन्ट्स टू कन्वे द मीनिंग ऑफ अदाता विद द वर्ड जंतु. ही हैज यूज्ड द वर्ड जंतु हियर टू कन्वे अ पर्सन हू डज नॉट गिव चैरिटी. किंतु तत्र न अभिदायकम्, इट डज नॉट हैव द केपेबिलिटी ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग दैट मीनिंग. Okay, hence there is the dosha. If there is any questions with this, you can ask. Okay, yathava, otherwise he gives another easier shlokam to understand. I had to give the two meanings because there are people who have seen this before. What is the meaning? 1 minute. I didn't understand your question, Kamakshi. Can you ask? Unmute yourself and ask.
இல்ல இந்த மாதிரி இப்போ இவர் தப்பா எடுத்துட்டிருக்கிற அர்த்தம் கான்டெக்ஸ்ட்க்கு ஏத்த மாதிரி எடுத்துக்காதது அதுவே தப்பா இருக்கு.
No, that I can't say that it is a dosham. See, he has taken it out of context and that itself cannot be considered as a dosham. See, interpreters, commentators have their own liberty to explain how it is. So Mallinatha has given a particular type of explanation for the shloka. Mammatacharya has given a different type of explanation and he's taken the word as differently. So that itself you can't say as a dosham. It is the dosha of the commentator. You can't call it as a dosham of the the poet, when we are talking about the doshas that is there in the poetry. Yeah. Okay. Next is a very simpler shlokam to understand as far as this dosha goes. Hadhik sakila tamasi shashimukhi drishta maya yatrasa tadvichyada ruja andhakaritam idam dagdham dinam kalpitam. किं कुर्मः कुशले सदैव विधुरो धाता न चेत् तत् कथं तादृक्यामवति मयो भवति मे नो जीवलोको अधुना. दिस् इस् अ वेरी ईजियर् श्लोक एस् ऐ सेड्. सो नायका इस् डिस्क्रैबिङ्ग् वाट् हि हेस् सीन् हर् इन् द स्वप्नं आर् हि हेस् सीन् हर् इन् द नैट्. So some vyakhyatas say that it is in Vikram Urvashiyam where Pururavas is describing Urvashi whom he has seen in the Swapnam or during the night. But it is not found in Vikram Urvashiya Natakam. Hence you can just say take it as Nayaka and Nayika. So the Nayaka has seen the Nayika either at night or he has seen her in Swapna. So the first line is Ha Dik Sa Kila तामसी सा किल शशिमुखी. सा शशिमुखी तामसी दृष्टा मया. यत्र सा शशिमुखी दृष्टा सा तामसी अधुना नास्ति. सो वेन् ऐ हेव् सीन् हर् ड्यूरिङ्ग् द नैट् यत्र रात्रौ सा दट् नायिका शशिमुखी नायिका. Shashimukhi means one who has a beautiful moon, beautiful face like the moon. So Shashimukhi sa naika yatra drishta sa tamasi ratrihi sa ratrihi tamasi kila. The MVM goes like this. Each line is like a sentence here. So hadik is like alas or ayyo, you know, you say that, right? So it is in vishade. So hadik यत्र यस्मिन् यस्यां रात्रौ इन् ड्यूरिङ्ग् विच् नैट् सा शशिमुखी दृष्टा. सो देर् आर् टु सा देर् एण्ड् वन् इस् टुवर्ड्स् द रात्रि एण्ड् दि अदर् इस् शशिमुखी आर् द नायिका. सो या शशिमुखी दृष्टा दट् नायिका हू वास् सीन् बै मी यत्र इन् ड्यूरिङ्ग् दट् नैट् सा तामसी किल. दट् नैट् वास् वेरी डार्क् during that time and she was like the moon shining. So there was no moon during that night And she, her face was the moon for me. That's why he uses, instead of Nayika or Mugdha, Daita, any of those words can be used here instead of the Nayika. He uses Shashimukhi to say that it was a very dark night and her face was like a Chandra for me. So, Sa Shashimukhi, Yatra Drishta, Sa Ratrihi, Tamasi Kila. It was very dark during that time. Now, next, what happened? Idam Dinam, Dagdham Kalpitam, Tad Vicheda Ruja, Andhagaritam Kalpitam. Now, there is Prakasham. I have woken up from my sleep or the Ratri has gone and I am no longer with her. The Nayika has also gone away. Now it is Dinam. Prakasha Yuktam Asti. Right? So Dinam is used for Prakasham here. As I say itself, you will understand that Dinam is the problem here. The Prasiddhartham is actually, the actual meaning of Dinam is the whole day from morning to Sandhya time. It does not mean Prakasha at all. Dinam does not mean Prakasham. It can be Andhakara Yuktam also. But here he is trying to say Dinam Prakasham Andhakaritam Kalpitam. Why has it become dark for me? Because Tad Vicheda Tasyaha Vichedena Nayaki. You know, the Nayika is there. Nayikayaha Vichedena. Because of that Ruja, because of that wound that is there in my mind, because I'm separated from her, this day or the Prakasham has become Andhakaritam Kalpitam. It has become dark for me. Now, the word Dagdham is actually used as an adjective for Dinam. It is not Dagdha, literal meaning is burnt. It is used for Nindyam. It is a Lakshana. As a Lakshana, it is being used in the meaning of Nindyam, or that it has to be censured. How do I say that? He is blaming this. In Tamil, we use para pona nal, you know, as an adjective for that. So this day has been made, this Prakasham has been rendered dark. Why? Because tad vicheda ruja, because of the wound that is there by her viraha. Next, kim kurmaha kushale. Now, what can we do in this point? Viduraha saha dhata na chet katham. Now, if that Brahma is not, if this fate is not cruel, then why does he not make my entire world to become only that night? He could have made it like that, right? Brahma is capable of making anything in this world. Then he could have made this entire world of mine. Me jivalokaha aduna tadruk yamavati mayaha kim na karoti. He should have katham na karoti. So, kim kurmaha, what can I do in this situation? I am separated from that Nayika. Sadaiva vidhata viduraha nachet. If that Brahma is not vidura, kathoraha, if he is not cruel, tat katham, then why is he not making my entire world, me jivalokaha adhuna tadruk yamavati mayaha no bhavati, na bhavati ityartaha. No means na bhavati. He should have made, no is used in the form of negative here. So, no bhavati, and it should always combine with the kriya. Tadruk yamavati mayaha. Yamavati is nisha, ratri. Tadruk ratri mayaha katham vidhata evam na karoti mama jivalokaha. So, he is extremely cruel. If he is not cruel, he would not be doing this to me. In fact, he would have, if he is very karuna yuktaha, then he would have made my entire world as that night when I was with her. I was with her continuously, or I was seeing her in that swapnam, then he would have made both my dinam and my ratri to be only that ratri. You get the meaning of the shloka? Now, atra dinam iti prakasha prakasham ayam ityarthe avachakam. So the word dinam means day. It does not mean prakasham. But and prakasham ayam prakasham iti arthe. Prakasham ayam, sorry. I'm splitting it in a very wrong manner. So prakashamayam ityarthe, it is completely filled with prakasha or light. In that sense, it cannot avachakam. Avachakam means it cannot convey that meaning. You understand? It does not express that meaning of prakashamayam, whereas dinam means only day. That is the dosham here. Next is upasarga. Yetcha upasarga samsargat arthantarakatham. Because of the upasarga, there is actually a totally different meaning. Upasargat dhatvartaha anitraniyate. When you add an upasarga to a dhatu, the meaning of that dhatu expressed completely changes. It does not necessarily only embellishes the meaning of the dhatu, it can completely take off something different. Harati means you are taking something. Saha pustakam harati, in the sense of nayati. Whereas if you say saha pustakam praharati, it does not mean prakarshena harati. It does not mean that he is taking it in a very careful manner. No, that is not the meaning that is conveyed always. Praharati means he is hitting it. So pustakam praharati means he is beating that pustakam. So the meaning of the word completely changes with the upasarga, the prefix of a dhatu. So what does he say here? Janga akanta uru nalaha naka kirana lasat kesara kesarali karalaha pratyagralaktaka abha prasara kisalayaha manju manjari bhringaha bhartur nrittanukare jayati nijatanu swachha lavanya vapi sambhuta ambhoja shobham vidadhat abhinavaha dandapadaha bhavanyaha. The problem here is vidadhat. I'll explain that later. The shlokam is a very beautiful shlokam. Bhavanyaha dandapadaha jayati. Bhartuhu nritta anukare. When following, so here he is talking about how Bhavani, Gauri, Parvati's dandapadaha. Dandapadaha is a very specific natya terminology that is being used here. Her foot. Let's take it as foot for now. I'll explain what it is. So bhavanyaha dandapadaha, her foot, when during the nrittavanukare, when she is trying to follow her husband's bhartuhu nritta anukare, when she is trying to follow her husband's dance or Shiva's dance, that foot of Bhavani jayati sarvotkarshena vartate ityartha. Jayati does not mean she wins. She is in a battlefield and that foot is fighting and it is winning. No. Sarvotkarshena vartate ityartha. It shines forth beautifully as superior to everything else in this world. So how is that foot? Dandapadaha. Dandapadaha ityukte. There are two, three meanings here. The meaning that the Vyakhyata is saying is prasahya urdvikritaha padaha dandapadaha abhidhiyate. In Sangeeta Ratnakara, where the foot has been taken urdvikritaha, the foot is stretched forth in the atop, right? Urdvam kritam. Yat urdhvam kritaha padaha is dandapadaha, and it is standing like a staff. Usually in the south there is a tradition, there is a story where, you know, the Bhagavan was dancing, Shiva was dancing, and his kundalam fell down, and he took that with his leg and put it by lifting his leg up. And Parvati could not follow that because ladies are not supposed to lift their leg up. No, actually in Sangeeta Ratnakara, it is defined that Dandapada is a type that is where the lady also lifts up her leg. That is there. Okay. It could be a difference between the south and the north viewpoint. I'm not sure. But dandapadam, if you look at, I think some other dance also says where you one leg is kunchitam and the other leg is just stretched forward, and that is called dandapada. There are differences of opinions as far as that. In this shloka, we have to take dandapada as urdhvikritaha, where Bhavani is lifting her leg up. Now, her body is described as a lavanya vapi. Nija tanu swachha lavanya vapi, and this leg that she lifts up, pada pankajam, and it resembles a lotus that comes out in that padam, okay, sorry, in the in from her body. So imagine her body as a vapi, which is like a flowing river, and nija tanu, her own body, which is swachha lavanya, which has a beautiful beauty, which is pure, and that is compared to a vapi, a river or a tank. In that sambhuta amboja shobham vidadat, it bears the, her Bhavani's foot bears the beauty, shobha, of an amboja, a lotus flower, which has come about in that tank or that river of beauty. Now, the other, everything else is an adjective to that, dandapadaha. Jangha kanda uru nalaha. Her thigh is jangha kandam. Jangha kandam is the knee in her foot is like the node that is there in the nalam or the lotus stalk. Lotus stalk is her thigh, uru nalaha. Her thigh is resembles a lotus stalk. Jangha, the knee that is there, is the node the, where the padam attaches itself to it. So that is like the, you know, a small node that is there in this lotus stalk. So jangha kanda uru nalaha. Naka kirana lasatu, the nails are all kiranam, the rays that come out of her nails are lasatu, shining like the kesara, the pollen grains. Ali is pankti, the you know, the kesaram has a straight line which forms a line, so that is karala, which is up and down. So all pollen grains will not be standing, all those pollen stamens that are there in the lotus will not be standing in a straight line and of the same height. One will be up and one will be down. In the same way, Bhavani's foot is also up and down. All the this thing will not be in a straight line, right? Like, you know, if you look at a child's drawing, it will all be in a straight line. But that is not how naturally it is. It will be karalaha vishamaha nimnonnatam. It will be up and down. So, naka kirana lasat kesara ali karalaha dandapadaha. Next is pratyagra alaktakabha prasara kisalayaha. There are some small sprouts of leaves that are there in a lotus. And that here in her Bhavani Pada, it is Pratyagra Alaktaka Abha. She is wearing that Alaktaka Rasam, which is that Alta, and that is like the Kisalaya. Manju Manjira Bhringaha. She is wearing Nupuram, and that Nupura is making a sound very beautifully, Manju Manjiram, and it resembles the Bhringa, the bees that are that surround a lotus. So, tadrishaha dandapadaha bhavanyaha bhartuhu anukare jayati. And it has the beauty of an amboja, amboja shobham vidadati. Now, here, dadati, the word dadati has the meaning of dharanam, shobham dharati. Whereas vidadati, actually, he is trying to use the meaning of visheshena dharati. Possesses an extra beauty. Okay, or it possesses. The meaning of possession is being used in vidadati. But actually, the vi purvakam, atra dadati ityarthe vidadati iti upayujyate. Kintu vidadati ityatra karanam eva artham. It is making the beauty of a lotus. That cannot happen. So vidadati means karoti, whereas dadati means dharati. There is a difference between possessing and making. It naturally possesses the beauty of a lotus. The Devi is not making that beauty of a lotus, right? So shobham karoti iti tatra arthaha bhavati. So it cannot express the meaning of dharati, whereas vidadati is actually meaning karoti. The poet wants uses that word as to mean dharati or possessing. Okay, you get the idea here. So here the word vidadati has been used in the sense of bearing, whereas the prefix actually, if you use the word prefix, it will mean only karoti and not dharati. So that is the dosha here. Shloka is beautiful. What to do? Mm-hmm. Okay, we'll stop with this. The next section is Ashleelam. We'll take that during next class. If you have any doubts, you can send it later. I will address it during the next class. Okay. Namaste.